This segment is sponsored by Our Home Magazine.
Our next guest is featured in this current issue of Our Home Magazine. We're joined today by Lori Mitchell. She's an artist and creator of these beautiful whimsical figurines that we see behind her. Lori, it's wonderful to see you.
Oh, thank you so much for having me. It's such an honor to be on with you.
It's absolutely our pleasure. I am so excited to get to the story behind these beautiful creations. You make these whimsical figurines. We see them lined up behind you. Where on earth did this inspiration begin?
Well, I would say most likely with my mother. She was an elementary school teacher and she absolutely loved children's literature and particularly picture books. So when I got to college age and decided that I was going to go to art school, I became an illustration major, thinking maybe I would go in the path of children's books. And it was just kind of a saturated market. And I started taking some three-dimensional classes and a paper mache technique just really kind of hit home with me. So they're my stills of characters that you might see in the movies or in books and, you know, just really come from my childhood and inspiration of my own three children. So it's been a fun journey.
I love that. Illustrations really almost come to life. When you see these whimsical figurines, what do you hear from fans who collect your creations regularly? How do they make them feel? What feelings do they evoke?
It just reminds them, you know, of their own children or holidays, just that nostalgic quality, I think, that we all long for, particularly this time of year. But really any, I decorate for all of the seasons and I create for all of the seasons. And it's really just about kind of that inner childhood spirit and, you know, wanting to hold on to that and share that as much as possible with other people.
And it's fun. I took a quick trip to your social feed. I was visiting you on Instagram and I was looking and you're right. Of course, your creations celebrate all sorts of times throughout the year. And what's fun is I could see how this would really quickly balloon. As soon as you have one, you want to have friends. That's what's fun about it. When you put them together, are they really kind of in your mind telling a story in that same way you were inspired by illustrations?
Absolutely. I do call them my little people. They are my little friends. I get to spend all day with them, which is so much fun. It's really, you know, it's just fun. And I love color and texture. And so when I'm creating sets that are supposed to be together, like the Nativity behind me or the Nutcracker, then I'm definitely thinking about colors and heights and the way that they will work together. But really you can piece any of them together and they tell a little story, and that's what's fun about them.
They really are. As you see the Nutcracker behind you, of course, or the Nativity, they just really bring these stories to life in so many ways in a fun and incredibly whimsical way. Your creations, of course, you're based here in Richmond now. You mentioned when you studied the Rhode Island School of Design, which is incredible background. And of course, you relocated here to Richmond many years later. You're here, but these creations are going across the world.
They are. So I'm represented. I'm fortunate to work with a wonderful company in Ohio, and they help spread the word, and they do the business end of it so that I can stick with the creating and doing the product development. We mostly attend all of the shows here in the United States, but we do have people that come from other countries and also purchase for their stores and then take them back to their countries. So it's really fun to know that I've got little creations in all corners of the world and hopefully bringing joy to the people that they reside with now.
Absolutely. As these make journeys across the world, I would imagine then that kind of doubly inspires you, and maybe you can take that into a storyline as these continue to evolve. You know, as we kind of wrap up this morning, how many are you able to create each year? How does this come to light, and what have you found to be the most inspirational thing for you, where you're like, that needs to be a figurine?
Well, I do about 30 designs a year currently. I no longer sell my original work since I'm focusing on the reproduction line, and I do all the product development with ESC and company. My three children are constant inspiration, and they do come first, so that's hence why there's 30 designs a year. You know, as they age and I have more time, I will certainly, you know, have endless inspiration to add to all the collections and the pieces. But I really think it's holding on to my childhood, watching my children grow, wanting to create memories for them that they can pass on. And that's really where the inspiration comes from. I can watch a current movie. I could watch an old movie. I can look at a beautiful piece of fabric that I just love the way the colors work and they remind me of something. So inspiration is really all around.
Well, we appreciate you sharing this whimsical inspiration with us this morning on Virginia This Morning. Lori Mitchell, thank you so much.
Thank you, Jessica. Have a wonderful holiday season.
You too as well. We'll share all the information so friends can find you and bring a little bit of whimsy into their lives too.
Thank you.
You can find Lori Mitchell on Instagram at lorik.mitchell. Her items are available through online and local retail shops, including Janet Brown Interiors right down the street at Arthur Ashe Boulevard and at Tinker's shop on Westwood Avenue. Find Our Home Magazine on newsstands today or subscribe at richmondmagazine.com/home. You'll find them on Facebook at Our Home Magazine and on Instagram at Our Home Mag. The things that she does has so much personality and so much thought goes into them. I was looking at one of the little scenes where she had the little boy and the girl in the little girl had on a Christmas sweater, and the boy is holding a present. But what I noticed most about it was their Christmas tree behind them, and the top was leaning over because the star was too heavy, I guess. And it's like the detail is amazing in that. I mean, just talent off the scale.
I always find artists so fascinating because, yes, her creations are just out of this world. They're beautiful and so intricate, and to have the talent to be able to put those together. But what was so interesting, and we really just started to explore it, was her background as an illustrator, you know, with really like pen to paper and being inspired by movies, how she manages to take those inspirations and then form it into a 3D, to have gone from a 2D rendering to like a 3D actual figure, just boggles my mind. How do you sit down and do that?
Well, and it gives it depth and it gives it dimension. And obviously it kind of comes, I have no idea how you do it, but it works. And it is amazing to me. Creative people that can look at the same thing you and I look at and all these things burst out of that one thing and we're going, oh, that's nice. And they're going like, boom, boom, boom. All of these ideas are just popping out of their heads and all the detail and all the, you know, I can't draw a stick man. So,
well,
it's amazing.
That's right. I like to say that we all have our talents in different areas of life. And clearly, Lori has found hers. You know, you see those collections and you were looking over her shoulder at the different, you know, the nativity and the nutcracker. And it fills your heart with warmth because they're creative. You know, they're coming from her inspiration. They're brought to life. Anyway, we have drooled all over Lori Mitchell because she is fantastic. I so enjoyed talking with her. So yeah, that's fun. Be careful when you pick one of them up, Mr. Bevins, because next thing you know, the whole nutcracker is going to be on a shelf.
A bunch of them. You betcha. And stick around because we've got a lot more fun right after we come back.